Last time on Essential Viewing Collection, we reviewed Record 2, an intricately woven haunting fairy tale where we learn that sometimes we find love in the most unexpected of places, and that everything isn't always as it seems.
All right. We also learn that sometimes a zombie isn't just a zombie. And sometimes a zombie is just a zombie. It really just depends what you're talking about. Either you're talking about zombies or you're not. Well, you get the zombies that, you know, they died. They come back to life and they're dead. They were dead. No, that's a technical zombie. And then you got the other zombies. They're not technically a zombie because it's some kind of virus. You know, they never really died. Now they're acting just like the other ones. And you tell me, yeah, it's not a zombie, but I'm saying whatever. It's a zombie because they're acting like it. So whatever.
There are three types of zombie movies. Social commentary zombie movies.
Who are the real monsters?
Zombie comedies.
So meta, you know? Just so meta.
And then everything else. It's the everything else category where you'll find the good zombie movies. Movies like Record 2, Night of the Living Dead, and Dawn of the Dead. Not the 1978 George Romero Dawn of the Dead. That's a social commentary zombie movie. Something about how the zombies are mirroring our consumer lifestyle or some such BS.
So, how we shop at the mall is exactly how the zombies are shopping at the mall. I get it. I see it.
Sometimes you gotta have a movie about what people might actually do in a zombie outbreak situation, rather than some stupid message about human nature and society.
I'll tell you what, if there was a zombie outbreak, there's no way you'd ever be able to count on me. I'd be murdering everybody. Everyone I see just for their shoes. Or because I just want to murder someone.
That's exactly the point. Stop trying to tell me that people are evil at heart. There's no way everything would descend into anarchy just because the police department is busy with a few zombies.
I was being serious. You're first. I'm gonna get those shoes. That's where Zack Snyder's 2004 reimagining of Dawn of the Dead comes in. We managed to get through the whole apocalypse without anyone trying to rape each other.
Even the character that's supposed to be the most morally reprehensible was only acting that way to protect himself. And he ends up working with the others by the end anyway, the way it would probably happen in real life, because that's the smartest thing to do. He knows he's not getting anywhere being a jerk.
The whole movie is like that. People are constantly dealing with situations that might actually happen, and responding in the way they might actually respond. What's more, the stupid decisions are always proven to be stupid, and nothing bad ever happens on account of one of the smart characters. It's the dumb idiots that cause all the trouble. Like this hot air balloon who almost gets everyone killed over a dog. A dog! The zombies don't want to eat the dog, you sexy twit!
That's why we love this movie. It's all about the zombies and how to deal with them, and it's very light on the drama. And even the drama is only about the zombies. This scene is a great demonstration. Max Headroom got bit, so Anna is giving everyone crap about wanting to kill him.
Well, Michael, what are you waiting for? Go ahead, kill him. Hey, kill Tucker, too.
Wait a minute. I was never bit.
We can't be sure. Do it, Michael.
She's wrong, and later on she's proven wrong. He needs to be dealt with because he's dangerous.
This movie doesn't waste any time. The zombie outbreak is already underway before it even starts. The following 13 minutes is a preposterously exciting and believable depiction of the spread of the undead, complete with real-life footage of rioting and chaos mixed with fake real-life footage of zombies that really sells the whole scenario. This 13-minute opening ends up being the best part of the movie. The rest keeps up the momentum with an even distribution of energy and remission that's never not about the zombies.
It never feels like it's slowing down to have a picnic. Or another picnic. Or another one. Like what happens in 28 Picnics Later. The movie has more picnics than it does zombies.
Could do with a little more of that undead spread. You should never forget about the zombies while watching a zombie movie, and that's our biggest problem with other movies in this category.
That's not saying that this one doesn't have any problems. The zombie baby is retarded. The situation it creates is good, it's dramatic and interesting and very cool. But the idea of a zombie baby being born is an abortion. And it looks stupid. That zombie baby was a mistake. And also, the idea was a mistake. Also, we hate the Richard Cheese part. It's not very good. They could have left it out and nobody would miss it.
Then it'd be 1% better. And I wouldn't mind that. Then there's the speed at which Anna gets over her husband being dead and zombified. Everyone that has seen the movie has noticed this. It's weird. It's just odd. They do a really good job at building up their relationship at the beginning, you know, with pictures, naked showering, and intimate talks of their future. Then, husband dies and zombifies, no mention of him ever again.
Who cares about that guy? He's a jerkhole. He tried to eat me.
Except when she does mention him.
I watched it happen. I felt her pulse. She was gone. Then, yesterday I saw the same thing happen to somebody else.
Somebody else?
Holy crap, that's your husband. That's cold. It's cold in this movie.
Then she and Best Buy are suddenly making all out after no real build of any relationship. What a hoe. Your husband is off somewhere, eating someone hotter and younger, and you don't even care.
It's freezing in here. The ending was great, but then it tested poorly, so they reshot it and managed to make it even better. Simply by adding a few found footage clips to the credits, they built a whole epilogue detailing what happens immediately after the ending proper. And then they played Down with the Sickness, and I hate that song.
Now, let's get down with the serious. Dawn of the Dead is awesome.
No, it isn't. I hate that movie. It stops dead while bikers wreck up the place for like 10 minutes. It's boring.
Shut up! It's a good movie! Keeps up the pace, story's always going somewhere. Zombies all the time!
No, it's boring and slow and it doesn't move.
What?
It's as slow as the zombies are slow.
Shut up!
It's going along and then it stops dead for 10 friggin' minutes while the zombies stumble around looking like idiots. Slow.
You got wrinkles on your forehead. Maybe it's because you're slow.
Maybe it's because you're not even talking about the same movie I'm talking about.
Maybe it's because you're not talking about the same movie I am.
I'm talking about Dawn of the Dead, 2004, Zack Snyder, awesome movie.
What?
You're talking about Dawn of the Dead, 1978, slow and boring slow. You just don't know what makes a good zombie movie. It ain't about morals and human nature and societal commentary bullcrap. It's about the zombies. The zombies are out there. Now what are we gonna do about it?
Well, the television said that's the right thing to do. We've got to get to a rescue station.
Man, I wish there was a zombie outbreak. I have so many shoes, I wouldn't even know what to do with myself.
You could just go to the shoe store at the...
No!
Dawn of the Dead is a remake done right for once. Rather than just making the same movie again, it takes the concept and rejuvenates it with a new direction and purpose. And we are proud to call it just one of our Twin Perfect Essential Viewing Collection, a list of movies we think should set the standard in momentum for all movies henceforth.
This collection demands that we all just take a step back and, you know, a closer look at the big picture. And really pay attention to what we might be seeing or learning.
What?
We have to be aware of what's playing out before us and not let it be that of dismal quality.
What are you talking
about? Don't just watch a movie because it's something to do. Watch it because it's something you like to do. And that way, you'll get more out of the movies you're watching. Or making. Or renting. Then it sits on the table mall for a few days and it's like, oh man, I forgot to watch that movie and now it's due. And then you take it back. Right?
That's, yeah, pretty much.